And now, another episode of Crit Camp Gaming.
It's episode 66, and damn it, Matt. I was hoping you were going to have a Mega Man hat on.
Nah, maybe later, dude. You get deep in my Bloody Mary and I fail an important role, we'll consider.
I also love your camera framing. It changes throughout the show. Like you're like bottom right screen, and then
my girlfriend came in and attacked me, bro.
Aww.
Sorry.
She gonna get you. But what's up, everyone in chat? It's good to see you guys. It's Monday. It's June 13th. It's episode 66. We're heading to mission 2 of season 3, Rumorg. We're making our way through the season 3 of Zombicide. It's a great game. Cool mini or not. And we're looking forward to doing it with you guys. Lyle, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing all right, man.
Yeah?
Doing all right.
Yeah, what's new? You see Matt's here?
I do see that Matt's here. Yeah,
check that out.
Yeah. The Salt Master himself.
Yeah, the Salt Master himself. He's returning to play some more Zombicide with us guys. The last time he joined us for Zombicide, he got really mad.
Dude, yeah. Give it another go, bro. I'm ready.
That was a past season.
No. This time we're playing like a legit campaign mission now. Not some extra mission that was not playtested.
That's right.
Deeply playtested. Okay.
Yeah. And Sean Patterson, right off the bat, welcome to the camp. Glad to have you. We're hanging out with Matt, who hopefully won't dump too much salt on the game, as you guys have heard. But yeah, we're gonna move some stuff along. It's gonna be great. But I wanted to see what's going on with Lyle. I mean, I just wanted to say, what's going on, man?
Nothing much, man. I had had a good weekend. Was really bummed to be back to work today.
What did you do this weekend?
On Saturday, I went to the Belmont Stakes.
Yeah.
Oh, I bet on the ponies.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Did you win a lot of money?
I won one bet of the... I made 2 to 3 bets on every race, and I won one bet. So, you know, I'm in the red.
How much did you win? Yeah. You know what? It only takes one bet.
Yeah.
How much
I won
did you win?
$9 on that.
It only takes that mentality to go bankrupt also.
So
no,
how
dude,
much did
all
you
I need... No, no, no. There's the, yeah, I need, all I need is a dollar and a dream.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you got to be win it. You got to be in it to win it. That's all it is.
So. If you'd bet 5 cents on all the other past races, you'd be crazy up.
But I bet a lot more than that.
Crazy up, dude.
It hurt.
That sounds like fun, man.
Yeah, and then yesterday I was took a nice long drive upstate New York. I went to a glass blowing studio and I got a couple pendant lights for my kitchen island.
Yeah, looking good. Yeah. Can we see them?
You want to see it?
Yeah, show me your pendant lights, man. You went all the way north of the wall to get pendant lights. He went and spent 20 Gwent on...
Dude, 20 Gwent.
He went up Terraria style, and he bought pumpkin lights to hang in his...
All right, hold on. Take it out of this thing.
He pulled it out of his piano. As all you guys
I got a couple of these. Let me put the headphones back on.
So show and tell.
You blew that yourself.
I did not blow this myself.
Nah, you did.
But
it is blown.
There it is.
Nice.
That's a hand blown glass pendant. I got a couple of these.
Well done. Look at you upgrading your Terraria household.
Oh,
now,
yeah.
Now someone
right.
can move
dude,
in. You have a light source.
Right next to like my ghostly banner and my Skeletron banner. It's going to be really great.
Someone will move into your home. Maybe you can get like the Armorsmith or something like that.
All right. Hold on. I'll put this up.
Matt, what did you do this weekend, buddy? You were telling me earlier while we were hanging out that you went to an escape room.
Oh, yeah, I forgot
about
that.
Tell me about your escape room, man. I've always wanted to do one of those.
Dude, oh, there are so many things that happened this weekend. The escape room was awesome. So, escape room, like, Shannon set it up, and we did this, like, quadra date.
Yeah.
I guess. So, what we ended up doing is we had, I guess, 8 of us in there, and it was, like, this cabin murder mystery, right? And so the deal was that, like, we had to go in and find, like, there's this killer named Simon Says. We had to find out, like, his name, the name of his victim, where he buried her. Hmm. And so you just go into this room and there's, like, you know, nothing except for, like, a lantern and a black light and a bunch of locked crap. And you just start doing stuff. And it was really fun. Like, everybody just kind of, like, helped out. And we found, like, a closet that, like, when you pulled a special chain, opened a giant secret passage, which connected to another door. Oh, my God, it was so cool,
and you went
man.
To, like, another room and stuff? So it's, like, a multi-room?
Yeah, it's a four-room
thing. That
sounds
awesome.
It was so cool. And so Shannon picked the one that was the most us-themed, like, as a group, which was, like, this serial killer one. Yeah. And it was also had the lowest success rate. So it was really cool.
Did you successfully pull it off?
We did. She gave us a couple hints we didn't ask for, of which we only ended up actually needing one. But we got started late. Shannon, she got there late, bro.
Yeah.
She let us down. But don't worry.
That kind of reminds me. Remember when we did our Halloween stream with Shannon? It was just me, yeah, you, and Shannon. Yeah. What game are we playing? And we were freaking out.
Oh, it was Nightmare. Dungeon Nightmare. Dungeon Nightmare. Yeah. That was creepy as hell. I was like running around. I just ran away.
It's scary, man.
That was a freaky game, man. Yeah, go back and watch that, guys. That's exciting. Basically, it's Shannon just laughing her ass off at Lyle and I going.
And yeah, and just yelling at you.
We definitely have to do that again. That was fun. We'll have to find another one. But awesome, man. I've always wanted to do one of those escape room things. I was a big fan of there was a show called. It was kind of a different thing. I know the escape room thing's more of a puzzle type, like almost like RL adventure game, right?
The escape room itself?
Oh yeah, it's like a point and click, but you get to do it.
Yeah. Exactly right.
Yeah, dude, I want to do that so bad. I love those kind of shows. Like I forget the name of it. It was called Solitaire. I don't know if anyone ever watched that show, that TV show.
Oh, that was cool.
That was great. And you all in your own rooms, and you have to like outcompete each other, except for the whole sit on the stick thing. That would not have done well on that. Or eat a bunch of bananas. Like, look up Solitaire on Netflix, Lau.
I think it's called Solitary.
Or it's Solitary. It's like the game. It's okay. Like the game.
Solitary Confinement.
Yeah. Gotcha. And it's like 12 people all in their own room, and there's a central hub, and it's got like the,
does each person have the same exact puzzle they have to solve in the room?
They have challenges. They're like challenged, and you have to out-survive everyone else, and you don't know how many people are left. So if you give up, and you give up too early, you're out. But you have to try to outlast the other people and understand, like, see if you can like out like wit them. You have to out like just like not sleep. Like they'll pump in just like babies crying for hours and hours nonstop, and like you just eventually.
It actually sounds like torture, dude.
Oh, it is.
Sounds like it literally sounds like torture.
Look it up. Well, anyone else out there?
It actually did have some pretty negative repercussions on the existing mental health of the people after they left the room.
Oh, sure.
I did have some stuff.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. I mean, you would know.
So you're saying that like they were blasting like babies crying and then some heavy metal and then they did a little waterboarding and then they
kind of right. I mean, like they put them in some really messed up situations.
It is, and I think just being in solitary, completely in solitary, and not having somebody talk to you or anything talk to you for like 48 hours.
And there's like this little red glowing ball, kind of like what's his name, Hal, right?
Yeah.
And she talks to you. And she comes in and you have to like, she becomes your friend and then she like really messes with your head and like, oh, it's brutal, man.
It's great. Yeah. Okay.
It's pretty bad. Check it out. It's great.
Yeah.
So Matt's also here because we want to announce, like we've been talking about, we've been teasing it a little bit. Matt's super psyched. We're going to start a Kingdom Death series as well on the Crit Camp stream. So woo.
Yeah. Woo.
Matt's really big fan of Kingdom Death Monster. He helped him and his friends help support the Kickstarter, right?
Yeah.
So he's got copies of it at his house. I know you guys, we've mentioned to you guys in chat and everything. You guys are excited about the whole thing. Yeah, it's like GLaDOS. but yeah, Kingdom Death, we're excited to get that going. And we're going to launch it on June 23rd. We'll talk about it more and promote it more come next week and stuff like that. But Matt, we were testing out Kingdom Death today and it's going really well.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
What happened in Kingdom Death today?
What?
So I lost my nuts today in Kingdom Death.
Yeah, he had a bad night out on the trail, and a bug literally came and removed his genitals, and he woke up with a completely smooth surface, and a disorder because of it. That happened to you. We also discovered a field covered in white lion urine.
Yeah, that was nice.
We weren't sure what to do with it.
Yeah, yep.
All right.
I think at one point, no, the lion didn't pee everywhere. He could have.
No, we came after he'd peed everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This game's great, guys.
And though... It's this game is real. It's not only cool mechanically, like combat wise, but the lore and the RPG elements are so like just clever and well thought up. So
yeah, I love the deep stuff. It's gonna be fun. So we'll be starting off with us three and Dave, and then we'll be swapping in someone as like a guest slot. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
Cool.
So check it out, Thursday, June 23rd. We're gonna start our Kingdom Death playthrough. We'll of course keep Zombicide Season 3 going. And then another game I wanted to mention is that I think we might start it like for video game wise throwing the game Kria, if you guys have checked that out. But Otherwise, yeah, thanks for hanging out with us so much. And everyone out there, thank you so much for your YouTube comments. Sky Knight has been hitting us up like crazy from the last episode. I will read through them some more. He caught a couple things we messed up a little bit. We're still getting a little funky here, got past the QC team, but we'll do our best to always, we always appreciate those comments, and even on Twitter and stuff like that. So keep them coming. I just wanted to give a shout out to you guys.
And I also want to give a shout out to Evil Ed, who said that he has now watched all of our Zombicide videos.
Nice. Evil Ed has, and yeah, man, right on. That means you get this, dude. You get some applause. That deserves some applause.
Awesome, dude.
Good work. Good work, dude. What are we going to start calling that? Hashtag Crit Camp Iron Man?
Yeah, dude, yeah, it's an Iron Man.
Yeah, if you can watch all our Zombicide videos from the very beginning, go to the YouTube channel. You can watch them all. Because we've got a few of you in there, man. I think Blip a Doozy's going through it. He's on episode 12. We love hearing you guys do that, and we want to hear your reactions. I love getting the comments on our YouTube videos from, like, episode 13, and someone, like, asks a question about why we did something. And I was like,
I don't know, man.
I'm like, can you give me a time? Like, give me a timestamp. Like, it's real helpful. I love that you guys do it. It's so exciting to see that you do that, but... Oh, Robo says he just skipped all the ones we lost. But those are all the exciting moments.
Dude, nice.
The ones we've lost are exciting moments. Majay's in the Iron Man Club. Of course, man. That's awesome. And good to see you. Majay just did this the whole time and yelled a lot.
Yeah, he was disappointed in you.
Yeah, yeah. But for all you Zombicide fans, yeah, definitely. We appreciate that. We want to hear from you guys what you're thinking. And we mentioned it on the last stream, Zombicide Season 1. We were just talking about Kingdom Death. We're going to be doing it on Tabletop Sim. It'll be our first like digital board game series stream completely, but Zombicide Season 1 mod, Dave and I were messing around a little bit, Dave from the new Nerd in Town, and it's awesome. I would highly recommend you go check it out. They put a lot of time and put in some good money. You've got like 3D backgrounds surrounding you. You've got all the elements and pieces. They break it down pretty well that you have the rule book out and it works so well. Everything's smooth. It didn't crash once. Just go check it out. It's really cool. I mean, there was a few funky things, you know, but you just have to get used to playing in Tabletop Sim to get, you know, used to how that flows. Like, Matt and I are kind of realizing.
Yeah. It can be rough and tumble.
But it works really well, wouldn't you say, Matt, for, like, board game stuff? I mean,
oh, God, it's so awesome, man. When it works and everything's flowing well, it's, like, it feels really good. There's some huge advantages over even having it in person because we can all just touch and manipulate things really easily, and you can see what people are looking at, and I don't know. It's really cool. I like it.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited to get into it and see what more we can do with it. But so go check out the Zombicide mod over there. I believe Cool Mini or Not officially released it to him. It's about $10 on Steam right now. So go get it if you don't, or if you have Tabletop Sim. It's a mod. It's DLC technically, Evil Ed. You do download it, but you purchase it on Steam and then it'll auto download into your tabletop app. It's kind of weird. It's not like you download a game and then you open up Tabletop Sim and then it works. You kind of Tabletop Sim, they've got the workshop stuff for stuff like Kingdom Death mod. We did Cell Swords a long time ago with Brad, and it's like that. It's not like that. It's better than that. Check it out. I definitely highly recommend it. Was that your cat?
No, that was Casey.
What is wrong with her? She like, hard day at work? I kind of want to know.
No, I mean, she's blown some glass,
she just got home a little bit ago.
Yeah, did she like chuck a book at
she's
the wall?
She's doing some... Whoa.
We just got
what happened here? I got Skype, dude.
Yeah, I think you guys need to pop your cameras back. Oh, it's going to swap your cameras. Are you kidding me? Dude, Skype's been doing this. I heard it's been doing it to some other podcasters and streamers and stuff, too.
Says
Casey's tiptoeing away now.
I need Skype Premium. It's telling me I need something else to make a premium video call.
What? It's Skype? Are we starting to get Skyped? Is Skype going to start...
Skype.
But Lyle looks good, guys. Look at that. He's got a little spinny ball.
Am I there?
No.
Am I there yet? Because...
No.
Here he comes. No? We're just about to talk about what we're drinking, and then we're going to get into this.
I'm going to stop my video, and then I'm going to re-enable my video.
Give me your videos, guys.
Am I there? Because I am on my screen.
Oh, Matt's back. He's in Lyle's box.
Oh, yeah. I see Matt
Dude,
now.
Lyle. Can I ask you guys a question while Lyle's loading?
Yeah, let's do that while Lyle's cat is loading.
Why is everyone all quiet about the big event that happened this weekend?
E3?
The big event called Warcraft the movie.
No spoilers, man. We can't talk about it.
I'm not talking about what happened in the movie Warcraft based on the game that came out 20 years ago. I'm talking about just, are people hype? Are you excited? Did anyone else see it?
I have not seen it yet.
I haven't seen it.
We're going to, me, Chris, and Angelo are going to try to see it together. Mm-hmm. I don't know when that's going to happen.
Yeah.
Chris is not excited at all to see it. And I'm sort of lukewarm on it, but I definitely want to see it. I'm lukewarm on my excitement level, but I do want to see it.
I'm lukewarm. I think it's going to be like an Avatar. Like, I don't really, the animation kind of bugs me, and I'm kind of worried. Like, the one thing I do like about it is you've got a lot of people that are kind of like going into it that are Hearthstone or World of Warcraft lore fans, but they don't realize. And tell me if I'm right with this,
man. Am I back, though?
No, you're still spinning white cat.
All right, hold on. I'm going to rejoin the call.
Okay, cool. So some people don't realize, well, this is fun. Matt's in two windows. But like, what some people don't realize is that the story in that movie has to do with like the RTS lore.
Yeah, well, it has to do with this whole world's lore too. It's just,
well, to come up into that. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's just, this is the way that I describe it, that I've talked about, is that it's not World of Warcraft the movie. It's Warcraft 1, Orcs and Humans, the movie. And all of those things are referenced in World of Warcraft the game. But you have to dig deep for them. So I don't
please
know, man.
Please give me the vision, sir. All right.
I feel like I shouldn't. Yeah, I don't want to say anything nice or good about it because, like, people like to be naysayers. So yeah, it was shit. I wouldn't see it. It's bad.
prove me wrong. Terrible. You're like, prove me wrong. Prove
we're
me
swapped.
Wrong.
Mike Morheim.
We're swapped.
We're swapped. All right, follow both of them. Just follow both these guys.
Follow both of us.
Yeah, follow both these guys. It's freaking wrong. I'll fix it in the gameplay screen when we get in there. But Lyle, what are you drinking?
I am drinking a Ballast Point Piper Down Scottish Ale. Ballast is from San Diego?
Yeah. San Diego.
Near where Robo is.
Sculpin. Amazing IPA from them. Love it.
Yeah, the Sculpin is good.
Oh, love that stuff. Love that stuff. Wait, who's over there?
What?
Who's over there, you said?
Robo's on the West Coast. I don't know exactly where, but
he's on that coast closer there of Hawaii. He's on the eastern coast of Hawaii, pretty close to that over there. But Napalm's drinking the water, of course. Right on. Matt,
Napalm, what's up, man?
What's up, Matt? Napalm's in the house. Matt, what are you drinking?
Dude, I made a giant Bloody Mary because I knew I wouldn't have another chance. So this is all Bloody Mary.
Oh, Jesus.
Sweet, dude.
It's gonna take time. Don't worry, it's not like super powerful or anything.
No, I'm just saying, like, I'm not a Bloody Mary fan. I can't do the Bloody Marys, man.
I had a few of those yesterday.
Yeah, drinking some soup, man.
Oh,
soup.
Robo's got a Sculpin. Nice. Glass of vino. Yemen. Is it oaky?
I like that, dude.
Would you describe it?
Yeah, tannins.
Tannins, do you taste it? So I'm drinking a I'm drinking a Westmalle Trappist Ale. This thing's awesome. Little Belgian ale. My dad got me a monthly, kind of like a, you know, a monthly beer thing for my birthday. So this was the first shipment. This is one of them.
Sorry, what was that? Was that like the symbol of the Masons on that? What's going on there?
Don't worry about it, dude. Westmalle Trappist Ale. This thing's awesome. I'm a big fan of Belgian ales. I've even got it in one of my favorite Belgian ales, my Delirium Tremens glass with my little elephants.
Malted lychee drink.
But, very good. It's a very good beer.
Dude, I want to try a malted lychee drink. Dude, great Biff tannins, man.
Oh, you guys are doing it up.
Yo, Blip's got a malted lychee drink. All right.
Oh,
all right.
Yeah. Is it lychee or lychee?
Blip's got the Bear Republic Rocket Ale. I've always had lychee. Nice. Bear Republic, good brewery. I think it's lychee.
That's the first time I've said the word in public.
Yeah, lychee.
I usually try to say it quietly in the shower.
It's like a shoot. It's like a. What do you call it?
Fruit.
Oh yeah, it's a fruit.
It's a shoot.
It's like a shoot.
It's kind of like a ladder as well.
Like a shoot rhymes with fruit. Yeah. Yep. That's the perfect one. Well, right on, guys. Let's get into this. I think it's time. I think we're well prepared. We've got our campers with us. This is awesome. We've got new campers joining. Everyone's having a good time.
Welcome.
Lyle is pronounced. You pronounced it correctly. Blip says.
Boom.
So you win. So it's lychee.
I got dominated.
It's lychee.
I was saying lychee.
Lychee.
Lyle, serve me, man.
All right, dude. You get owned. Get deaded. Up. All right.
Fleshy fruit? Okay.
Let's get into this game, guys. We're heading into no. Oh, did I spell now way out? Does that what
now
it says?
Now way out.
Oh, my
God. Yeah, you did.
I just realized it says
now way out, dude.
Because you knew, dude. You knew that now this is the way out because Matt's.
I looked down. I was like, wait a second. No, okay. No, it's correct. Now we have to take our screenshot from this.
Now, way out. Seriously, man. You and Lyle are there. No way out. I'm Matt in the mix.
You're gonna, yeah, now. That's a great screenshot with the names reversed.
Oh, screw it. Okay, we're getting into this. This is a disaster.
Yeah, production.
This is a disaster. All right. Names, whatever, dude. Suck it up. Okay, let's get into this. Let's jump over to our missing page for No Way Out from Rumorg Season 3, Next Level Production. Now, right, way
do
out.
Do the Flava Flav.
Yeah. My Jay says no way with a K N O W.
Yeah.
Would have been even better. The more you're lucky it didn't happen. Okay, here we go. Mission 2, No Way Out. It's an easy 6-plus survivor, 90-minute mission. Let's do a little lore. We should have known everything was going too well. We landed 2 hours ago to explore a promising area. We didn't expect the helicopter would lure a distant herd of zombie to our position. Now we're stuck in a worn building, trying to get back to the helicopter. Doors are destroyed. It's a matter of time before the zombies get inside. I love committing zombicides in close quarters. No, really. I do.
Dude, who said that, man?
Nice, dude.
Who's that a quote of?
I don't know, man. It's pretty intense, though. Because we got a zombie horde crossing.
Intense.
No, no. It's not. It's not a zombie horde. They pluralized it right there. It's zombie herd. That's what I just learned.
Oh, it is zombie herd. You're right.
Oh,
all right. A cackle of zombies is a zombie herd.
A zombie o herd.
Yes.
Zombie o herd. All right. So this mission, basically, we start in that blue tile in the upper left, and we all of us have to make it to the helicopter. And to get there, we have to go around this horseshoe shaped building, out the door, and into the helicopter pad. And we win if all of the starting survivors are in the exit zone at the end of the phase. There are a couple special things that are happening. The first being that we have an extra spawn die that we have to roll. So we, instead of 4, we will be rolling 5 spawn dice. Whoever picks up the objective, as per usual, will get 5 XP for that. And is there anything else? Oh, we can't fly the helicopter.
No, we will not. That's our exit point.
Yeah, that's just an exit point. We just can't.
Explain the event triggers for Maddie.
So the event trigger. So basically what happens here is when we're on a tile, once the first person gets onto a tile that has an event trigger, then we flip over that event trigger and it spawns all the rooms in that event or in that tile.
Are those the red X's?
No, those are the Riddler question marks.
Okay.
Yeah. And so basically, when we enter that tile, then we spawn all the rooms in that tile. And then as we go forward, we're going to have to keep
spawning. Gotcha.
Yeah. And in this one, it's a little different than the one we did last week, guys. So anyone who joined us for the Twitch stream, that was a kind of an intense extra mission. In this one, those question marks, once we leave that tile, it won't flip back over to a question mark.
Yeah, that was crazy in the last mission.
Yeah, it'll stay activated. It cannot be reactivated.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was pretty brutal for us in the last
one. Oh, and another major thing that's happening is all of the zombie spawn, they spawn at the yellow danger level.
That's right. We have to remember that.
Is that bad?
It's just more intense right after off the bat because we're still in blue level. They start at yellow. So that means more zombies spawn right away.
Okay.
Oh, and yep, people in chat had already said that.
Oh, okay, cool.
You guys are on it.
Yep, QC team is all ready to go. And Angelo's joining. And Daff, what's going on? Everybody's jumping in. Good stuff. I know, no Red Dead Redemption 2. I know we were going to talk some. Let's get over to our character selection screen, what we're going to be using. The E3, yeah, guys. You guys see anything fun at E3? Hear anything from E3? I have heard nothing that I'm really excited about.
Yeah, we're swapped again.
Oh, man, this one is swapped. I tried to jump on the other ones. Yeah, let us know, guys, what you were seeing at E3 that you're excited about. Because I was watching a little bit of the Microsoft thing today. I don't care about Gears of War. If you put one more Gears of War game out, no more Gears of War. I don't care about Gears of War and Killer Instinct. I don't care about Gears of War controllers. Oh, you guys Skyped again.
I got handsomer.
Oh my god.
Skype, you're a... Which one play a board game?
What
is going on? I saw 2 Lyles for a second, and my life got better.
Oh, I didn't see anything about. I didn't see the stuff about Resident Evil 7 yet. I saw the. What was the BioShock game?
Like,
I saw guys.
Oh, I like BioShock game. Oh, are you talking about the one that was like the Happy Few or something?
The Happy Few, yeah, something like that.
I see that.
With the Carney makeup dudes, it looked really cool. That was probably the best one I saw from what I watched so far.
You guys into it? Okay, there. I'm back, I think.
Yeah, Matt's back. Lyle's not back.
Oh my god, why is this taking forever?
But nonetheless, dude,
Let it sit.
We Happy Few looks awesome. Oh, dude, and I didn't see the Sony conference yet. Daff.
I mean, Resident Evil 6 was kind of like, it's too action adventure-y.
They got horrible after 5. 5 was the last one I wanted to put myself into.
4 was so cool. Yeah. They thought that that's what everybody wanted, but then they went too like hardcore in that direction.
The lore just went, what?
It went all hashtag bonkos.
And talk about bad like movie. Like talk about World of Warcraft. Man, if they make it, I've mentioned this a few times on here, those Resident Evil movies were horrible. Horrible. I don't care what you say. We weren't good. But, Lyle, we're still waiting for your spinning cat. But nonetheless, I swapped the cameras because it's going to screw me again. All right, yeah, so we're going to get into this as Lyle figures out his thing. I'm going to get into the character selection so we can get this moving. What do you say?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so I'll start off with mine as Lyle gets his kitty to stop spinning balls. We're getting Skype. Oh, he's back.
Oh, okay. Didn't do anything, but okay.
Skype, guys. We're sorry about that. Production value. Next level. All right, so Luis. I'm starting with Luis today, guys. As we just saw on the map and the board full, I'll do a little quick thing over here. Board full. So the board full over here, as you saw before, we're kind of inside the building. Now, these aren't the hospital tiles. And Matt, you should know in Rue Morgue, there's hospital tiles and there's these other tiles. So there's special hospital tiles. You can't search anywhere but in locker rooms in those tiles. We have none of those, so we don't need to worry about that.
Perfect.
In this, we can search in any of these rooms pretty much. So what I'm going to do for a character choice selection option is I'm going with Luis. Lyle's played her before, played her a few times.
Yep.
She gets plus one card to all her searches. Now, this doesn't mean I carry the flashlight card from past Zombicide seasons. It means she just can search, and I get two cards for every search.
Yep.
So I'll be searching it up and getting you guys gear.
Sweet. That's so what I like to hear.
Going Luis. She's a stock Zombicide Season 3 character. And then I'm going with Audrey. I used her with the Twitch guys last week, and I felt like she didn't really get used at all.
Yeah, she didn't get to use her Zombie Link, really.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, Zombie Link. Yeah, the whole Achilles, the reason Achilles OP... So basically, anytime an activations card's drawn, she gets it to take an extra turn immediately. She gets her actions, and then the zombies will spawn again.
That sounds pretty good.
Or activate, I should say.
Yep.
So Zombie Link's great. It's great for keeping things moving, getting us out of situations if stuff goes bad and we draw poorly, since we'll have six activation dice this time, meaning there'll be six zombie spawns every time the zombie activation happens.
Okay.
So I'm going with her, Big Bang Theory. Lyle.
I'm going with Bear, who I played with last week, which was pretty awesome. I think the shove ability is going to be pretty important here as we make our way through the building. So
yeah.
Just as a reminder, shove basically is I can use it once for free every turn, every time it's my turn. And basically I can shove all zombies that are in my zone into an adjacent zone.
Yes, he's a stock character from Zombicide Rue Morgue. That shove ability has been amazing.
That sounds pretty cool.
We've used it constantly, and when we don't have it, we miss it huge. Oh, and Hero Necromancer Ostaker from Black Plague starts with Zombie Link. Oh, that's cool. That's cool.
Ooh,
nice.
That's good to know. So, Bear, and then you're going with Parker.
Yeah, I'm going with Parker. I really was thinking about choosing Amy, guys, and chat. I know you guys want Amy.
Amy.
But I wanted to pick another of the Season 3 people. That, and I don't think we've used Parker before.
No, I don't think so.
And so she starts with Medic, and I figure we're probably going to go YOLO and hurt ourselves, so it might be nice to get somebody that can clean up some wounds.
That's right.
Okay.
That's good stuff.
Do I get to comment on mine with...
Sure, man.
...less info? Okay, good. Go ahead. I'm getting ready.
Uncle Honk. Uncle Honk.
Over there. Oh, okay, sorry. I was on the screen. All right. Uncle Honk. Uncle Honk, without a doubt, is the character Bear when he's at work during the day. So this is his alter ego. He has a bloody machete and taunt, which, if you have seen the character Axe from Dota 2, you'll know... means he can spin and decapitate everything. Actually, I was wrong. Okay. If the survivor can use the skill for free, once during each of his turns, select a zone your survivor can see. All zombies standing in the selected zone immediately gain an extra activation. They try to reach the taunting survivor while means available. All right. Yep. Taunted zombies ignore all other survivors. So they do not attack them off the zone. Stand in if needed to reach the taunting survivor. Yes. I will main tank for you.
Yeah, yes, basically. That's a come at me, bro.
Yeah, come at me, bro, taunting. Okay. Thank you right, so much for the follow, Dragon. Welcome to the camp. We're glad
what,
to have
you. What, Drogon?
I think Drogon, Dragon, Drogon? Did she
oh
come
God,
back?
Was Drogon is following us?
Drogon the Dragon?
Right, 2 weeks ago, we can't talk about this. I guess she was with... Was she with the Dragon 2 weeks ago?
Two weeks ago is the episode in which it ended...
With her on the Dragon.
With her doing the speech that we've heard before.
Yeah,
I was talking
and,
two weeks ago, Game of Thrones, worst. It's ended how they always end with her, and it's the worst. No, it's Dragon Cat Zero. What's going on? I saw Dragon, got excited. Welcome to the camp, Dragon. Thanks for joining us. Good
the
stuff.
Dragon Cat's really cool, though.
And just to mention, Uncle Hawk comes with the Kevin Walker guest box. There's a little promo guest box option. You can get this at cmon.com. comes with a couple different guys, including Mitch. Hmm. So Kevin Walker, go check him out. Good stuff. So then Matt, your second.
Your second character. The little bit of backstory is, I was looking at characters and I was like, oh, I can't wait to play this game. And I was like, oh, there's a bunch of hot chicks. Wait, I'm going to play this cool old woman with a flamethrower because not enough games do stuff with, like, older women. And then I heard that we played older women last week. So I decided to pick a hot chick. And this hot chick has two swords and a really open shirt. So I decided to go the other way once I found out I could play Rose. All right, so that's my backstory.
Oh, Gamergate, Gamergate.
Sorry, I didn't mean to say that with excitement.
Hashtag Gamergate, Gamergate.
I meant to say that with self-loathing. If this is a hot chick. All right, go ahead. Give me what Swordmaster is.
Tell me why I picked this one.
Oh.
All melee weapons can be dual wielded.
That's kick. Yeah. All right.
Yep. So you can beat stuff up even if it can't be beat up twice.
Perfect, man.
And she's part of another guest box. Matt's going all about the art. So Matt's got the Palo Parente guest box. And there you go, Maki right on the cover. Comes with a few other great guys. What's her name? Dylan. You can get Dylan with her. Awesome. Great artwork. Go get the CMON.com. These are great. Fun more characters to add to your Zombicide game. If you didn't get them in the Kickstarter, they're awesome. So definitely check them out. Maki. I'm glad. Maki's never been used.
Yep.
So Maki's joining the team. Let's start this
and
thing
up. And did we figure out where Maki's from?
No.
If she's from anything.
Anyone know what her likeness is supposed to be?
I couldn't find it, man.
Yeah, let us know what you guys think her likeness is supposed to be. But let's see what we're starting off. Matt, you're going to see some new weapons since we're pretty much, just so everyone knows, we're playing with the Season 3 equipment deck and the Toxic City Mall equipment deck, including all zombies from every single season, including Toxic City Mall. So Luis, starting with the bow.
Mm-hmm.
Audrey, starting with the crowbar.
All right.
Bear starts with a fire axe.
Very nice.
Parker starts with a crowbar. Uncle Honk, crowbar. Maki, bow.
Attack on the Titans.
Okay.
All right. So if Maki gets like a crowbar, she can dual wield crowbars if she gets another crowbar and stuff like that.
So I start with a bow, though.
You got you got dealt a bow to start with. Yeah.
Oh, this is random. This is random.
Yeah, this is a random starting thing. So I'm going to be starting the thing off with the Whis. Sounds good. Let's get into this game, guys. It's time to play No Way Out or Now Way Out, however you want to say it. Now Way. Now Way.
Now Way.
Now Way. Way.
He's not good gaming.
No way. No way. All right. Game time. Let's jump into it.
Napalm is saying the art boxes aren't pop culture derived.
Not pop culture derived.
Okay.
They are pop culture.
Yeah, I see what you did there, dude. That was meta. That was meta, dude.
All right. Let's get into this game. I threw a game at your face, Matt.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we're in this game. Let's start this thing off. So basically, we don't spawn any zombies just yet. All zombies will be spawning in yellow level. So yep. I think we're just kind of like gearing up.
We're gearing up and we're just going through this building.
Yeah. And I think we just make the push.
Yeah, dude. We're just going to get in a formation and we're just going to like slowly inch forward.
Right. And you guys will also see these X's. Style. These X's are objectives. We don't have to pick them up. They're just worth 5 XP if we just want to level up to yellow because we probably should.
We probably should level up to yellow as soon as we can just to match the zombie level.
Yeah, the zombie difficulty.
Okay.
All right, so I'm gonna move up and search.
Do we have to go in order in this game? I'm sorry, I can't remember.
Currently, so you have two here. You have two heroes. So you have two survivors.
But you choose which of your characters you want to activate first.
And we go clockwise. Chris, Lyle, Matt. Chris, Lyle,
yep.
Matt.
Chris, Lyle, Matt. Okay, so I'm just gonna.
It'll go Chris, me, you, and then the next turn will be me, you, Chris, and then the next turn after that will be you, Chris, me.
Right, gotcha. Yeah.
So I'm gonna move up and then search.
Sounds good, man.
So we'll move up one.
All right, and you get the double search.
Get my double search.
That's your talent.
Got a pistol and an assault rifle, dude. I am.
We are good now, dude. We are good.
And if Matt, you ever want to see something full, I can do this.
Dude, I think the bow is better than the pistol, dude.
Damage rate 6. Good at rolling sixes, bro.
You get a crit, you get a damage, but
I think I can understand what all those icons mean. I played
the bow. The bow is better than the pistol, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, it is, yeah. 3+1. Yeah, you're right. Okay, so I'm done there.
Yeah.
All right.
If I move forward, it will spawn those three rooms.
So you and you can each person explore search room only once, or is the room like now exhausted?
You can only search once. No, you can search that room again. You can only just search once on your turn once.
Okay.
Do I want to move forward?
Could Could you not have searched the room we started in, then move forward and search a second time?
No, I could have. No, you
listen,
can't
you
that.
Can you can spawn that room if you want. I mean, if all else fails, I'll just go into the room with you and then shove somebody over.
Hell yeah, let's keep this game moving, right?
Yeah, let's.
Should we just go super aggro here?
It's all right, man. I'm okay
so
with
we
that.
We got Bear, and we got Bear at his day job. Let's do this.
I got weapons. All right, let's do it.
Dude, and we have a medic too, so it's all good.
Okay, guys, we're going straight up the bat here.
spawn your spot last, by the way.
Yeah, so we're gonna be spawning these three rooms. Flipping this.
Zomblies.
Okay, here we go. I'm gonna spawn that one room to the far.
Oh, you don't have to go in there to activate it?
Two runners.
He is in there.
Oh.
Yeah, he's just purple. You can't see him too well.
Oh, well, on my screen he's one room to the right. He doesn't actually be in that center room?
Oh, no. If you enter the physical tile.
Yeah, the tile. Oh, so, see, this is tile six.
Fair enough. We're good. I'm good now.
Okay, cool. Okay, next card. A fatty,
all right.
That sounds bad.
Okay.
Last one.
And then a Skinner.
One Skinner.
Whoa. This is like, I got scared and serious.
Okay. I'm going to end my turn and go to Audrey. Audrey.
All right. See you later, JXM.
See you later, JXM. Sorry you don't have any headphones tonight. Thanks for swinging by, though, and saying hello. It's good to see you. May the crits be in our favor. Appreciate that. Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers. Buy some headphones.
Okay. So I'm going to go up there and just like punch with Audrey. I'm going to try to kill this thing. Because I've got weapons with my other character.
Okay.
Does that sound good?
All right,
that
Robo.
Sounds fine. Do it, dude.
All right, Robo. Doing this for you.
Crowbar it. Let's go. 4+.
I'm turning into a frat boy for you.
Oh, dude. What? What? You got all Greek? Got Greek in here, dude.
Nah, I don't know. I don't like this, Robo. It's hat. It looks like I'm... Like, you can't even tell it's a hat.
Where's your
hat,
dude?
What about this?
Dude, you turned it around, and suddenly you did it all for the nookie. I don't know what happened.
Dude, is this cool? We're doing this for a bit.
You did it for the cookie?
Yeah. What, limp biscuit.
Limp biscuit. All right, Lyle. Yeah, we start in the yellow spawn, Evil. That's one of the challenges.
Who's my other person? Parker? Parker Posey?
Parker.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
And what did she start with? What does she have?
Parker has the crowbar. Crowbar and the fire axe.
All right. Should I go in there and try to hack this thing?
You could.
Hack
but
the
you need
planet?
To be. You can shove for free, so that's true.
Yeah. So let me go in there with Parker. Go 1-2, and then I'll take a swing.
Activating Parker.
Yep.
1-2. Try to kill the Skinner. Skinner.
Yep.
Oh, it's a big one. Whiffa, big whiffa.
All right, Bear, do the same thing. Go 1-2.
Bear goes 1-2.
Yep.
Fire axe, 4+. Got him.
All right, there you go.
Nice. That looks real easy, bro.
Never been less scared.
All right, that's my turn.
All right, it's Maddie's turn.
So I have dude with crowbar and girl with gun.
Yep.
Or bow.
You have
with bow.
Yeah, you have a bow with Maki, right?
So I guess I can't dual wield anyway. I guess I'll just walk her a step forward and shoot my arrow, right? Is that how that works?
You could go 1-2 and try to shoot into that next zone, sure, if you want. Or you can surge. It's up to you.
Isn't there only one?
Yeah, the range of that thing is you can only shoot into the adjacent zone.
Right, so maybe I'm sorry. Maybe I'm misunderstanding the mechanics. Can I just walk forward? One room to the left, and then
no,
shoot
you need to go.
You'd have to do two rooms to the left.
Two rooms. You cannot shoot across multiple rooms indoors, and this range on this bow.
Oh, that's all
one.
Your guys. I thought those were zombies. Never mind. Yes, I get it. I was like, but there's dudes right next to me.
Yeah, I'm just gonna shoot dudes. I'm just gonna shoot dudes.
Don't move my homegirl, and let's shoot an arrow at something. Boom, boom.
Because she goes 1-2, and then shoots her bow, head to the fatty walker group.
I'm ready, bro.
Pack. Oh, and he gets the first
with the crit. First crit of the night.
Dude, easy,
Matt
dude.
Steps in and shows how it's done.
Dude, and that's like double damage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What does it say when you do that?
One plus one damage.
Plus you did two damage. So you only kill a walker first, though, right?
Yeah, it's shooting priority. It's walker first.
All right, dude. His head's pinned to the wall.
Yep. Thump. Got him.
I Joffrey, got him. Some kid.
Yeah,
got
him. So you activated and... Okay. Uncle Honk's turn. Got it.
Uncle Honk. Oh, yeah. Move that dude forward. I guess... Should I move in there and tank or just move into the room with you guys? Is there a reason to not?
You could search first if you want.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, search
Uncle,
and then just move
Uncle
in.
Uncle H. Yeah, he'll search.
You got a sword. The sword is three dice at 4+.
Dude, it's going
there
to
you
my
go,
girl.
Dude. You got your, you got
dude,
your RPG
nice.
Element right here. You got your dungeon crawler. Are you happy?
Yeah, I'm getting happier, bro. Getting happier.
And then you just want to move up with us?
Yeah, man, sounds good. Put me in there.
Yeah, why are we talking about over the top? In chat.
What's over the top?
The Sly Stallone movie. Arm about arm wrestling?
I don't know.
I don't know. I just saw Robo say it in the chat. I'm like, yeah. Why are we talking about this? It's so good.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do our zombie turn. So zombies move first.
Sorry, Robo. Here, turn it back. Which way?
Because we can.
Because we can talk about whatever movies we want. That's right. That's Crit Camp. You can talk about whatever you want.
Do you know what movie I was thinking about the other day that I was like sort of like wishing was on TV? The movie Iron Eagle. Does anybody remember this? A bunch of kids. They're all like Air Force kids, and they hang out on the Air Force base. And one of the guys' dads gets like becomes a POW, so he has to like with Louis Gossett Jr., who's training him. In like the flight simulators, he like steals one of like the F-16s and then goes like overseas to rescue his dad. No,
that sounds really cool,
dude. It's so good.
I was watching Cloak and Dagger the other day.
I was watching a 2-minute scene from the movie Ghost at Chris's request earlier, so that's all I've got going on.
His friend was a potter, so I told him.
I'm sorry. Which
live
which movie? I mean, which scene? The pottery wheel or
yeah, the pottery wheel?
The only scene in Ghost. Okay. Come on, man.
No, I mean, it could have been the one where Swayze goes inside of Whoopi Goldberg.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
And it gets all weird.
What do you remember the song that happens during the pottery wheel?
Is it Hungry Eyes? No, that's
the theme talk, the tabletop simulator, because that's all I remember.
Yeah, right. No, it was see if chat will get it.
My darling.
Yeah, that song. That's it.
Oh, yeah. What? Unchained Melody?
Yeah.
Hello. Time.
It's like
go.
We're doing this.
Ready.
No. Lyle, you have to be potting right now.
Goes by so slowly.
Okay, let's do this. So, Matt, a new thing in Zombicide Season 3. You guys can't really see it off to the right of the map. Right here is... 1, 2. So there's numbers on each of these spawn points, as you can see. Those correspond to what I'm going to roll on these dice, and that's where the zombies will spawn based on what we roll.
Okay.
So if we don't roll any 3-4s, that means no zombies spawn on that 3-4 point.
Easy.
Yeah, he's never been less scared.
No, I've been scared. I don't... So what, we spawn one zombie? No, that's really scary, dude.
We spawn 3 times at the 5-6 spawn on the north. Oh, sure. We spawn once on the 2 spawn, and we spawn once on the 3-4 spawn. That's what that means.
Okay.
And we're rolling with 5 dice before... Yeah, I mean, we mentioned it earlier. Lyle mentioned it earlier when we're breaking it down. This one of the other challenges, we normally only roll 4. They want us to add another dice because of the zombie herd. So
love zombie herds.
So I guess we'll start at 1. 1-2. So 1-2 gets 2 runners.
All right.
The 3 spot gets 3 Skinners, right?
I feel like I've seen the movie Cloak and Dagger and cannot remember what
Cloak and Dagger is about. The kid who like, I think he steals an identity or he knows someone's identity, and like the guy goes after him. But he's like, I love that movie. Love that movie.
I saw that.
Yeah.
I don't think I was allowed to. I was allowed to watch it when it came out, dude. Why is there like a little protractor on this card?
Oh, this means Skinners.
Yeah, that's just
it's a
blade.
Type of zombie.
Yeah,
it's a razor blade. It's
Yeah. It's for skinning. It's like when you skin yourself.
I get it now. I get it now, dude.
So he spawns
it's
3.
Like
oh.
this character. Dude, do zombies have knives?
They could. Oh, we got a walker.
Zombies. Waka, 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 waka.
Dude, I'm trying to understand, man.
It's just with the berserker walkers, you can't shoot them. You have to kill them by melee.
Kill them by melee.
Okay, yeah. So then two single walkers. Okay. So we have to remember up by that northern door, it's kind of hard to see right here, right below me here. There's a bunch of berserkers and walkers going to come inside.
Okay.
All right, Lyle. It's your go.
So there are things with us right now, right?
There are two runners, a walker, and a fatty.
All right, so let me hack the planet.
The bat got one. What do you want to kill?
I want to kill the fatty.
Oh, do you get melee? You get to choose?
Yeah, melee, you get to choose.
Yeah, girl.
Fatty dead.
Okay, now do it again. Let's hack.
Miss.
Oh, dear.
Okay.
Do it again.
Four.
Okay, get a runner.
I'm gonna ram him.
Okay. Do you want to push him?
I don't think I need to, right? We can take care of this.
We're gonna manhandle this thing.
Yeah. All right. So go to Parker. Parker Posey? Okay, swing.
Parker Posey swings. Gets a crit.
Yeah, we'll do that one.
Nice.
Ooh.
Pink. Okay.
All right, do another one.
Got
done. Dude. Cleared.
Boom. Sucker.
Now search.
Now search.
Search.
You got an MP5. MP5, three dice, four plus. You're lord out?
Dude, I'm lord out.
Dude, you got
Wait, am I lord out? Let me see
what
you
need
picture.
A sword. You need a sword.
I didn't realize MP3 players two generations later became submachine guns. But now I do. I'm learning a lot tonight.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The more you know, dude.
The more you know.
Rainbows. Hey, Uncle Honk, it's your turn.
All right. Now, how do I hand my two melee weapons to Girl and then have Girl hand Uncle Honk a bow?
You take one action to trade, and when you trade, you can do as many transfers as you want between two characters.
Girl wants two melee weapons, and boy wants bow.
Okay. That's your role, man.
Dude. All right. And that's one action, right?
Yep.
I'm going to move Big Dog left twice. I'll move him left once in search, I guess, to see if he can find himself a nice little melee weapon.
And we can remember, too, there's a X right below you. You can pick that up for 5 XP if you want.
Shit.
You get yellow level, you'll get an extra action.
Do you want me to do that with him?
You don't have any kills. Everyone else, I think, has killed at least one thing.
So I need this to be competitive? All right, I'll take that X, bro. If you want to give me that X.
It's up to you.
Oh, okay. Man. Sure, man.
You can take it. Someone should take it. Someone should take it to get us up an extra action.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're at 5 then.
Okay.
A girl has no bow.
A girl has no bow. That's good.
Nice. A girl has no bow. Boom, 5.
No spoilers. We can't talk about anything.
I know. We can't talk about anything in the last 2 weeks. We can talk about... what else happened to that besides ending poorly with Khaleesi? I don't even remember.
That episode ended poorly.
Can I use the last option to just search the room?
You could search the room we're in, sure.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no. You picked up the axe, though, didn't you?
Yeah, that was the second action.
Oh, that was the second action. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. Do you want to search?
Yeah, bro. Give me something sick.
Yeah, bro. Glass bottles, man.
Is that good?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
If we get the gasoline, we can make a Molotov.
You got the bottle.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Oh, nice. You did it, dude. Nice. Dinosaur Jr.
Took us long enough to get it. I'm going to use it. Boom. Okay.
I guess... Maki will search.
Maki's turn. Maki's going to search to start. Okay.
Boom.
Maki gets a rifle. So the rifle has one dice, 3+. You can get a...
I guess just put that in reserve. We're in and then I'll move forward a step. And I guess search again. I don't want to tank with her.
No, you can only search once per turn.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Well, move her up twice then. Let's live hard, dude.
Okay.
Live hard, eat, pray, love. Billy Roberts. Sure.
Yeah, eat, pray, love, man. Eat, pray, love.
Yeah.
Peace, good gaming. Eat, pray,
Peace,
love.
Peace, good game. Eat, pray, love.
Okay, so I'm going to move up one.
I was going to say gaze into the iris, but then I realized you guys have Max, and you can't get my reference because you don't have Overwatch.
Oh, no.
I don't want to talk about it.
There's a monk robot. There's a peace-loving monk robot, and he rules.
Okay, hollow points for the sniper rifle, rifle and evil twins. I could give that to you for your rifle if you want.
Okay. Urban mage.
And then urban mace. Urban mage is great. Two dice at 3+.
That's an urban mage, dude. That's definitely a G. That's not a C.
It does have a G. It does look like a G, doesn't it?
It's not a C. That's a G.
Period. Is it a mage?
Dude, it's an urban mage,
dude.
Which is kick
ass. I reference it, yeah. Is that actually how you... Is a mage an actual weapon?
No, it turns you into an urban mage, bro. I mean, look at it.
Sweet.
That's right.
I'm going all ranged right now. So I can probably, like, give that to Maki, man.
Oh, thanks, my Jay. I'm glad you said that to me. I didn't know that.
What?
That both my weapons have to be the same type in order for
yes,
me
they
to...
Yes, they do. Yeah, yeah. You have to have two swords or whatever. Or two urban mages.
Yeah,
two urban mages. I guess I would just mages in one hand and a melee in the other.
Right, actually, I'm gonna put my urban mage in instead of my bow.
Oh, yeah, you always call an urban mage. Yeah,
and does this hollow point work for my assault rifle? No.
Just rifle.
Okay. And then I'm going to move up. Okay. And then Audrey is going to move up one. Audrey's going to move up one. Do a big old search butt.
Mm-hmm.
Got another MP5.
Dude, we are so good right now.
And then I'm going to move up one more. We have to go some crazy melee after this next turn because of all the berserkers in front of us, but we got it. All
right, zombie turn. Let's move on them.
So if I have two of the same weapon, then I just roll all the dice for those
weapons? Yes. Okay. Yep.
So I need to get another thing. You can do... Dude, I need a second sword, I guess.
Dude, if you got another sword, it'd be sweet.
I mean, I can't dual wield... I mean, look at her picture. I need two swords. Just right there.
Yeah, the ultimate is if you got two chainsaws, that'd be amazing.
Oh my god.
You gotta lore out, man. You gotta lore out. If you got two
chainsaws with the
the knives? Can you do that? No.
No, I think does she get webbing?
Have you met Maki?
Oh no, no.
No, you don't get webbing. Boo butts.
Okay.
I don't know what boo butts webbing means, but it's
No, webbing means anything in your inventory is actually equipped in your hand. Yeah. You can consider everything that's
Whoa.
In your hand. So and there's knives, which give you like a +1 dice to your melee when equipped. So if you had two chainsaws and three knives, it'd be amazing.
That sounds really cool. Oh man, I want another sword bad though. I don't even know the sword stats. I just know I know one.
Sword's pretty good.
A walker's.
Waka 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 waka.
Texas Ranger.
You could have played him.
Well, you said walker. I don't know.
Yeah, we've never actually played with
Eagle Chaz.
Yeah, with Eagle Chaz.
With Chuck Norris. No one's played with Chuck Norris?
Oh, Skinner every manhole.
Skinner?
Two Skinners every manhole.
We're only on one tile, though, right?
So, wait, we're doing the blue one? I thought we had to do the yellow tier one for some reason.
We are doing the yellow. Yeah.
Why is the blue one pulsing?
Because we are at blue level.
Oh, that's the app doing that.
That's kind of a weird tweak they've done to the...
It's okay. I'm just trying to make sure I understand. That's a manhole. I aspire one day to be my Jay and has hit him.
Skinner?
Rules lawyer?
Dude, I love... Man, if you knew the amount of stuff I've been reading for Kingdom Death rules-wise...
Waka 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 waka!
So, Eric, why are you saying starting in yellow? Oh, paid off because we avoided an abomination?
Yeah, we did.
Is that... It would have been like...
We would have gotten one in that first spawn.
What a concept.
Well, that sounds spooky, Skinner. Dude.
Skinner?
Mm. All right, all right.
We've got a huge horde coming up on us here.
Is there a Matthew McConaughey at all in any of these characters?
He should be his character from True Detective Season 1.
Yeah, I don't know if there is a...
That is a missed opportunity.
Cool, you got to send a letter to Cool Mini or not.
Yeah.
Demand it. No, Guillotine Games. Demand it.
Yeah, dude. Party at the Moon Tower.
Captain saying in Black Plate he had Grom with two daggers, the same as knives, and Barbarian. I was regularly rolling
Grom
20
Hellscreep?
Dice.
Yeah, yeah, Grom Hellscreep?
Yeah, Grom Hellscreep?
No, that's Black Plague.
Oh, man.
I love these. Sailing the salt seas of cheese. What does that mean?
Dude, there's no salt here. There's only me trying to get Grom Hellscream into this game.
Yeah, exactly. Get that in there. It's kind of in Rum and Bones. You got orcs, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay, so that's it.
So,
That looks easy.
All right. Matt, you're up. Either Uncle Honk or your girl.
What color is my girl?
She's... What color is she?
Yeah,
she's purple. Green. She's right.
The dark green one?
She's up with the three group, okay. Up there with the pink. Okay.
Dude, is it time to... Nah, dude. If I had dual weapons, I'd go in. But right now, I'm going to go full-on baby mode. I'm going to move forward, and I think rifle.
Plus, remember, when we cross that line, we're getting on a new tile. So there's an event trigger under that group up there, too. So we have to spawn all five of those rooms.
So do I wait here like a little baby?
We're going to have to push forward eventually. We're going to have to fight hardcore. But you need to like almost get your dual wielding up. That would be awesome.
Then I guess I search, right?
Sure. You could start with a search.
If I can dual wield some stuff.
Yeah, if you can get a sword or a crowbar.
Okay.
I don't think crowbars were originally dual wieldable until season 3.
No, I mean, it's... Oh, yeah, yeah. They weren't, but now they are.
Yeah. You got plenty of ammo for pistols, evil twins, and rifle. So you got plenty of ammo for your rifle now. You can re-roll your rifle rolls.
Okay. I guess I'll move up. Oh, no, I can't move up. But it can only shoot one square, right?
Yep.
And you'll spawn all five of those rooms.
Isn't that, like, real scary? You want me to do this or not?
And you can't shoot the berserkers. You have to kill them with melee. The brown guys have to be killed with melee. You can only kill the walkers, the two blue guys.
Okay. I think I should AFK with her.
Okay, that's fine. We'll basically gear up and get ready for a big battle.
Give me a... Okay, so with Dr. Honk over there...
You can swap stuff. Maijay's recommending you put the rifle in hand so you can.
Oh yeah, no, I was saying I want the rifle in hand anyway. I thought I had to dual wield.
Do you want
to
swap out the crowbar?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, swap out the crowbar.
Okay,
yeah.
Most definitely.
You've got plenty of ammo.
Yeah, and do the trick with the plenty of ammo.
And plenty of ammo. I don't need that in the same slot, right?
No, that can be in your back pocket. It's a buff. Yeah.
All right, move. I guess with her, I take defensive stance. All right.
Okay.
Stance of the sturdy ox. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hold the line. Hold the line.
I'm going to explore with my bow wielding glass bottled clown, please.
You're kind of lore.
Yeah.
Kind of lore. If you could find a horn, you would be lore. You're kind of like this. I'll search.
Come out search, and play.
Oh, you got another MP5.
Dude,
we've got three MP5s in our crew.
I want a melee weapon, bro. I guess move Uncle Honk forward too.
Okay.
And yeah, I guess that's it.
He's getting ready.
He's ready, man.
In his turn. Okay, so I'm going to give up some of my stuff here.
Who are you standing with?
Who goes first next turn, too? It'll be me.
You go first.
And we've got a bunch of berserkers. I'm wondering if I should hold on to my urban mage
Dude, if you find an urban mage, you don't let go of it.
I'm wondering if I should hold on to it.
You just let it go so it can cast some shit.
I'm wondering if I should hold on to it to bust skulls. You know, the next turn? Because we're going to have a huge horde of berserkers that I have to use I have to kill by melee.
Yep.
So
you should definitely keep the urban mage.
I'm wondering what I can ditch to you guys. Like, I can give some stuff to Uncle Honk. He needs some stuff.
Give him some stuff.
Well, he doesn't need a ton of stuff.
No, he doesn't. But give him a melee weapon.
Uncle Honk has never been
Bear
less
scared. Bear needs some stuff.
Bear's scared, dude.
But
Bear
you're not stuff. In my spot. You're not in my spot. So I've got a ton of ranged, but you don't need ranged. But I want to search for stuff. So I'm going to ditch.
Just offload them, and then you can search.
I'm going to offload to Honk. Okay, Honk, you're getting Honk's
give him
getting a pistol and a bow? Or you already have a bow.
Well, give the hollow points to somebody too, right?
Oh, I've got the plus one damage with hollow points. We can kill a bomb with that now. Who's in my thing? Maki?
It's Audrey. you and Matt's people.
Oh, I'll pass him to Audrey. In case she needs to use the pistol. Actually, I'll do this. I'm going to give her the pistol and the hollow points like this.
Okay.
Okay, so Audrey's got it. I've got two spots.
You don't want Audrey to keep the melee weapon equipped for next turn?
I don't know if I do. Well, maybe, I guess. It's a crowbar, though. It's kind of crappy.
Okay.
Because I'm not going to move either, so I'm going to search with her and see if I get some more melee here. Another MP5. And plenty of ammo for shotguns. Great. We don't have any shotguns.
Yo, urban mages, dude. It just, is anybody else watching The Magicians on Sci-Fi?
More MP5s.
That season one. That season one was
What is
sick.
Everyone in chat saying?
I don't know if they're saying anything.
I don't know. I don't know how I should prep my dudes for our next fight. I definitely know I'm going to keep the urban mage on the waist.
Wait, I'm confused. I can see.
Get hollow points and ammo together for rifle. Oh, he's saying give it to the rifle. Majay's saying give him over to who has the rifle? Maki, right?
What I'm seeing in chat doesn't line up with what I'm seeing in this chat. Is that weird?
Oh, don't watch our screen chat. Don't watch the screen.
No, I was behind, but it's just missing certain things.
You have to watch the Twitch chat, yeah.
No, the stream chat.
No, we don't have the 44 mag. We don't have the 44 mag. Okay, so I'm just going to give my hollow point rounds over to you, Matt, since you have the rifle.
Yeah, dude. Bust me. Some hollow point rounds.
Nice.
That way you have a better chance of killing, like, a... Even though I kept them with my pistol.
Dude. I'm ready.
All right, so Maki's going to get hollow points and rerolls on her rifle. That means you do 2 damage with a rifle.
I know. Okay.
At 3+, which is great.
Okay.
And then I'm actually gonna swap the crowbar with the pistol, Lyle, like you're saying.
Okay.
Wait a minute. So we have access to 2 crowbars, right? I could dual wield crowbars.
Yeah, but they're not so great.
Look what's weird. I think it only says it's dual wieldable when it's on Matt's character.
Yeah.
Because see that?
I think Eric said the same thing earlier in the chat. That on her, for her screen particularly,
yeah.
any melee weapon automatically gets a dual wield symbol on it.
Oh, okay, cool.
But only when it's equipped on her.
Okay, so I guess I'm done. I guess it's your turn. Bear or Parker?
Okay.
Right? Did I end my turn? No. Now it's your turn.
Oh.
Wait.
Luis's turn.
I already took Luis's turn, didn't I?
I thought you did, yeah. Yeah, you did the searching, the trading, and stuff like that. But the app get crazy?
Oh, there it goes.
Okay.
Maybe I didn't end turns and just moved ahead.
Okay. Yeah. Well, Bear's going to search.
Bear's going to search.
Classic Bear, dude.
Yep.
44 mag.
Oh, there
Speak
is
the
a 44
devil.
Mag.
Speak of the devil, Captain. Captain was All just right. asking if we got that. So now you can put the 44 mag with the hollow points and you can kill a bomb.
Cool. So go west-west. Meet up with the team. Parker's going to search.
What does medic mean?
It means I can remove 1 wound for free.
There's one chainsaw.
Nice.
I put the chainsaw into the crowbar. All right.
Get that over to Matt.
West-west.
All right.
Roll 10 dice. All right. West-west. In turn. Zombie turn.
Scared. So plenty of ammo, like normally do you have to like reload a gun or something, or how's plenty of ammo work?
Plenty of ammo just gives you a free reroll if you don't like your roll.
Oh, that's all. Okay.
Yeah.
And hollow points include for damage.
Yeah.
Okay. So far I'm not seeing any doors open and we automatically lose without any control over it. So I'm into that. What's that? What is that?
Look at that crappy roll. 4 2s and a 1.
That's a 1, okay.
Oh, yeah, it's a head. It represents a 1. Okay, gotcha. Let's do this spawn. We'll take an edit break here. So this is all spawning in that 1-2 spot, which is great. I just want to do a quick check. I think all doors are open. I just want to make 100% sure that all the doors are supposed to start open. 1, 2, 3. Yes, they do. Okay, we're good. 100%. Okay, here we go. Spawning. In yellow still. Okay, Skinner.
Skinner?
Got one Skinner. We got 2 Skinner runners.
Skinner?
Okay, two Skinner runners. One Waka.
Waka, 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 Waka.
Fatty's extra turn. That means that Audrey gets a turn right now. And then the Fatty get a turn. But there's no Fatty, so they don't even have to activate. But I get an extra turn right now with Audrey before I spawn the last spawn card.
You can sense them.
So, Audrey, I'm going to fire off my MP5 is what I'm going to do. I'm going to kill these walkers. Blah, 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 blah. I got one. Bing. Okay, there's one. I'm going to fire again. Blah, 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 blah. I killed three with a crit.
Nice.
Problem is, dude. With that crit, it only kills one thing. I killed three, but I only killed one thing.
So that's why?
Oops. Because there's only one walker left in there. I can't shoot berserkers.
You can't shoot berserkers.
Oh, you just had a gun. Gotcha.
Yeah, you have to shoot them with melee.
I'm learning.
Oh, dude, Evil Ed, Mr. Robot was so good. Season 2 starts next month, and I'm pumped.
Okay, we got three crits. And then that's it. I'm not going to do anything else. Do I dare a search right now?
Why is that bad?
If I can get a zombie, but it can't attack us because we're in the spawn.
Zombies are babies. Search. Get me a sword. Zombies.
Oh, I got you a sword. See?
Oh, nice.
Woo! I mean, yeah, dude. You search. You get Maki a sword, and she goes full off Ginsu in the next room.
Okay, we got the sword, buddy.
I'm really into that right there.
Shoot them with the melee, yeah. Okay, and then we got to spawn one more zombie.
Ready?
Ready? Boom. Oh, I got another activation.
Yo, another activation.
So she gets another activation, and then the Skinners go.
Yep.
Does she have a... I guess she can go melee with her.
So I got three more actions with her.
Dang, dude, Zombie Link OP.
I should have put the sword... So I should have put the sword here, right?
Yeah, man.
Okay, so...
Obvs.
I could jump in.
Yeah, well, there's no more spawns. Get in there.
Well, yeah, they can't attack. We already went through the attack phase.
Yeah.
So I'm jumping in, boys. I'm jumping
in. Yeah, man. Obvs. Get this chick with her Molotov and her Tommy gun.
One?
She doesn't have either of.
Two swipes at this. Three dice, four plus. Shing.
Oh, this looks TV, dude.
One crit.
Crit. That was hard to watch, though, if I'm going to be honest with you.
It's pretty bad.
Oh, wait. Yeah, you moved up, so you spawned the tile.
Oh, boy. That's fine. We want that. We don't care. We're not scared. Okay. It was going to happen anyway.
I still kill one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So kill one. Let's spawn this tile.
How many actions do you take?
No, Maje. It's okay. We need this.
Only took one.
We want.
Oh, wait. Maje. Yeah. Is there no event tile? Oh, no. There isn't a event tile.
It's underneath me right here.
Yeah. Don't worry, Maje. Don't worry. I'm not concerned.
This is a little scary, but Matt's
no, it's not scary. You're
just spawn your thing last.
Okay, so I'm gonna start in the bottom left. And then we have one more, right?
Or did no, you do the last one. That was what gave you the second zombie link, bro.
Okay, but we gotta remember to activate the Skinners.
Yeah, activate the Skinners at the very, very end.
After
of this.
I do these five. So this could get confusing.
Sure. Which are the Skinners?
The yellow ones.
And what do they do?
They just move, but if you kill them, if you shoot a few and you get a one on a die, it turns into a crawler.
Ah, okay.
And then you have to kill that.
No problem, man. Farm the XP out of this crap.
Okay, so here we go. Let's start. Bottom left, this is getting intense. Mm-hmm. We got two Berserker runners.
Two Berserker runners.
Yeah, cool.
Two Berserker runners.
Yep.
Another Berserker runner.
Yep. It's getting crazy. Okay, three more.
Walkers.
Two OG walkers.
Waka, waka, waka.
One aggro town here. Next one. Two Berserker fatties.
Okay.
What does Berserker mean?
We can only kill them by melee.
Ah, okay. So, yeah, that's the adjective. So we have walkers, fatties, skinners, and we have...
So, yeah, walkers, fatties, runners, and abominations are just, like, the base sort of like
and then one walker
styles waka, of zombie
waka, waka, waka.
And then we have the toxic variety, which means
you don't want to melee them.
Yeah, you don't want to melee them. You just want to shoot them. The berserkers you can only melee, and then the skinners can come back as crawlers.
Okay, so I still have. Okay, so we're done there. Now,
right, you have one more action left with Audrey, and then you have
skinner activation,
and then you have a skinner activation.
Okay,
this is gonna be fine.
Okay, I'm gonna swing my sword one more time. Swing.
Does taunt
three with a crit? That's an epic.
Crit.
Does three? Does taunt cost me an AP?
No. Taunt's free.
And that gives them a turn, but forces them to move forward. And so they have to already be in your square to hit you, right?
Yes, they have to be in your square to hit you. Unless they're runners, runners inherently get two actions.
There's literally no way that you're even able to comprehend the level of the plays I'm going to make later on.
Okay, so Audrey's done.
Okay, now the skinners activate.
Now the skinners.
Good. One less AP for me to spend. Get them up here.
It's the skinner walkers, not the runners. Right?
The card said looked like it said
go back and look at it?
No.
Well, let's check. QA team, was it walkers or runners?
I don't know if they're actually individual. Oh, I guess there are in the other cards. So I think it
in
was
the other
walkers.
Cards they are. I think they were just walkers.
Let me check. I'm sure QC team will get it. Yeah, there are Skinner Walkers extra activation. It was Skinners. I mean Skinner Walkers. Okay.
Yep, that's what Blip says too, Skinner Walkers. Thanks, Blip.
Remember the Lotor Two Towers guy, the guy running to the wall with the torch. He's a berserker. Thank you for giving me a very clear visual reference. Perfect.
You gonna pop your W and then hit him with your D?
I'm gonna yeah.
No, I
didn't. No. I'm gonna Podwick. Okay, so then we have one more active. I have one more spawn, right?
Yeah. What'd you say? Podrig.
Podrick.
The squire to Brienne?
I squire. I don't want to spoil any of that conversation.
Yeah, you should
either.
Probably shut your mouth, bro.
Yeah, listen. We've always loved Pod, dude.
Pod's the man. His magic.
In general, dude. And the ladies love Pod.
Ladies
we know
love
that.
Pod.
I can't wait for Brienne of Tarth character in this game right here.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
Black
dude.
Leg.
Dude,
awesome.
Be so
oh,
sweet.
Yeah, dude.
Brienne of Tarth all day.
Dude, oath keeping all day.
We're done with all the other
activations,
right?
I bet on
right?
a horse at the Belmont, specifically because the name of the horse was Oath Keeper, and it came dead last, and I was like, thanks, Brienne.
There's no spoilers. That was no spoilers.
Dude.
You mentioned Game of Thrones. They'll freak out.
wait.
So are we done? Am I done with all the...
Yeah, because it was the last one popped your second zombie activation.
Okay.
So I think we're good.
There's no more zombies that need to be spawned, right? We're on to the next round.
We're on to the next round.
Okay. Yeah, and I think this is Lyle's round, right?
Okay, Okay, because we're
I think Chris starts this round.
Yeah, I
right?
start this one.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we're going to take a quick edit break, guys. We're going to be back for part two. Things got crazy. We got activated another thing. I'm going to turn the camera so you can see it better as well. A little production value. Everyone's freaking out about the game. Come on, if we watch the Game of Thrones, okay, just watch it. If you're gonna come to this show, watch the Game of Thrones. It's a great show. It's number one. It's the best show.
It's huge.
I hope Podrick gets like a Donald Trump accent. It's great. Ladies love me. It's good. I'm probably number one.
That sounds
in
really
Marines.
Good.
I'm probably going to go to Marine and be number one. Ladies love me. Yeah. Khaleesi. Khaleesi's all right.
I'm really into new Padre.
Look, Khaleesi, I love her. She's good. She's great. But she's a loser. She's a loser. Look, I get it. You can be burned. Can't be burned. Good. The Unsullied. Yeah, okay. I get it. But they're losers. All right, guys. We'll be back for part two. Of No Way Out, Mission 2 from Rue Morgue.